Hello and welcome to the online learning session KNX IoT Dashboard Server, Further Functions and Features. Our online learning session takes around 30 minutes, maybe a bit more with your question. The focus is always on a special topic or product with some special functions. Today it's again the IoT Dashboard Server with some more functions and features we would like to show. Yeah, my name is Thorsten Reibel from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings, and also with us is Jürgen Schilder, and he will present today. So still today, I will send you a PDF of the presentation, though the presentation is not that much today. It's more a demonstration of all the functions, but wait for our final feedback email together with a recorded video, of course, and also the presentation again. As you might see, I'm not in the home office today. I'm in Heidelberg in the factory in the training room Edison. But still, we are working mainly from home, and so our next work will be also offering you some sessions, either online learning sessions or the webinars. And already tomorrow we have some more for you, but I come to this later. So I hand over to Jürgen now. He will present today in just a moment.
Hello and welcome. My name is Jürgen Schilder, and I present the main part of this online learning session. Today, I show you further functions and the features of the IoT Dashboard Server DBS/S. Now, what is on the agenda? I start with a short introduction about the IoT Dashboard Server. Then I come to the topics of the couplers, line couplers or IP router, and the ETS filter table entries, followed by the IoT Dashboard tool software, where we create our dashboard with a different control elements. I like to add some elements like shutter, DALI RGB element, for example, or also trend viewer. Then I come to the topic of the IoT dashboard web user interface. So I show you everything live, real, in practice, with, for example, the registration of the device in the My Building portals and the DALI manager application. So mostly I will show everything live in the IoT dashboard tool software and in the web user interface. I hope not that we get some technical problems. So some words about this online learning session today. It is the continuation of the former online learning session about the basic commissioning we have given 2 weeks ago in the July 2020. So for more details, how to create a project and to synchronize it via the ETS and to do the first steps, the first download and so on, you can find them in the presentation of this former online learning session. It is still available, the link in our training database, or you can find it also in our YouTube channel. So some words about this IoT dashboard. It is a new kind, the easy kind of, for example, of operation of a building, of a smart building system. So we can operate it from outside the building, for example, or inside the building. We can do light control, blinds, shutters, HVAC, or also see some analog values. All the things are possible. It's an intuitive way, so we need no experience in visualization, like, for example, a system integrator who creates the dashboard, because we have pre-programmed frames and elements. So we have only to link addresses, similar like we do it in the ETS. So here, for example, you can see a screenshot of the IoT dashboard with a different control elements, like here for shutter or for HVAC controller, or to see here some values like CO2, or to operate here via this element, for example, the color of LED strips controlled via DALI gateway. This is what we want to do today. So a short overview of the complete system. So the heart is our IoT dashboard server, DBS/S, connected to KNX via twisted pair, or he can also communicate via KNX NetIP. This is a topic also I show you later. So then we need at first the ETS project. So we do it like before. We create our ETS project, we download the devices and so on. Then we need our IoT dashboard tool, a software, which is also free of charge. Here we create our dashboard, we add our controls, we link the group addresses, and then we download this project into the IoT dashboard server. For the synchronization between the dashboard tool and the ETS, we need another app, the so-called IoT dashboard ETS app, which you can also download for free of charge from the KNX.org online shop. So for the operation or to see all the status in the building, we use here our IoT dashboard, so a standard browser, like for example here on the laptop or via the tablet. And from outside the building, we can have access via the My Building portals. Additional applications are available, for example, the DALI Manager app, which I show you also today. So let me start with the first steps we have done in the last online learning session, how we create such a project, to add here our control elements. On the right side, we have the group addresses, and then via drag and drop, we link here our group addresses for switching, status, dimming, and so on. So then we upload this project into the IoT dashboard server, and via the IP address, we have access to our IoT dashboard server, and then we can operate and see, for example, here some values. This is a typical situation. Good, when everything so far is okay, we have to do some more steps. Very important is, what about is our filter table entries in the line couplers or in the IP routers? So for this step, we have to synchronize at the end, again, our created project and the IoT dashboard tool with the ETS. So we click on the button and then all link group addresses we have used in the IoT dashboard tool are now linked to the group objects in the IoT dashboard server. So depending on the group addresses, the ETS calculates the filter table entries. And the last step is we have to download these new filter table entries into our line couplers or IP routers. So it depends if the IoT dashboard server communicates via twisted pair or IP, which you will see in the next slides. So the easiest way is to download all the IP routers or the line coupler is, you go here to the ETS and on top you have here one folder, which is a so-called dynamic folder. When you click on the dynamic folder, we have as default a so-called modified devices view. So when you click on modified devices, you will see on the right side a list of all devices which must be downloaded. So you see here in the IP router, the group address flag is now missing, which means we have now to upload these two devices. So we can also start the upload here from this view, modified devices. Good, here you can see the example of the filter table entries when we use the communication via IP. So what does it mean? Our IoT dashboard server communicates via LAN port 1 or LAN port 2. Here in this example, we have the communication via LAN port number 2. And here via KNX NetIP, we have the communication to our IP routers and of course with other devices. So and then the IoT dashboard server gets the individual address, for example, not in a line because we are here maybe on the backbone level. So here in this line, we have used the group address 311 for switching the light, and this group address must be also here in our filter table. And this happens automatically when we at the end synchronize and download these filter table entries into the IP router. The same like here, this group address 0471 is also used only maybe here local. And then it comes here in our filter table and it is forwarded here on KNX NetIP. And we can see the group address, the status here later in our dashboard server. In this case, when we have communication via KNX NetIP, we have to use the ETS application DBS/IP. So we have two ETS applications. One is for the IP communication, and the other application is the so-called TP application. This is when we have to use it when we have a communication via twisted pair. So like here on this slide, you can see the IoT dashboard server communicates via twisted pair. Then he gets a local or individual address 937, like a device here in the line 93. Oh, and then the filter table entries have to be again calculated by the ETS, that the group address, which is used here in this line, for example, is now forwarded via this IP router. Here via KNX NetIP comes to this IP router, and now it is forwarded here in the line that we can see here, for example, the status. So this happens, this calculation of the filter table automatically in the ETS, but do not forget the last step is, after we have finished our project, we have made a download via dashboard tool to upload the new filter table entries here to our IP routers or line couplers. It depends on your used media. Good, then let's come to the most part of today, the practical demonstration. So here in my office at home, my home office, I have a small installation here with an IoT dashboard server, which communicates via KNX twisted pair. I've connected here some control elements, switch actuator, DALI gateway, room temperature controller, and via the rockers, I can operate here, for example, a switch actuator and control here also my LED strips with different colors, with different groups, red, green, blue, and so on. And what I want to do now is, for example, to add more elements, yeah, and use also some more functionality. So I have still prepared a project with some elements, like we have done it in the last online learning session. And based on this one, we continue now. So just a second, I share now my desktop. So here you can see my ETS project, which is maybe with the name IoT DBS Hotel Heidelberg. Everything is now still done. I have created here my building view. I have created all my group addresses. Here, for example, is my room 301. I have here all my devices. The devices are still downloaded. You see all 5 flags are here set. The address, programming parameter, group, configuration flag. Everything is now done. The installation is still running. Everything now is fine. Okay, this is the first step. You see also the group addresses are here created. Everything is now done. So, and then we come to the next step. We start now via the IoT dashboard tool software and we synchronize it with our ETS project. You do it when you create a new project, then you can say synchronize it with this ETS project. Good, everything now is still done. After the synchronization, you can see here on the left side our complete building view. So the IoT dashboard tool synchronizes the structure with the ETS. You see here again my hotel, my main tower, my different floors. For example, here my guest room 301. And in this room, I have here this control for switching the light to see the room temperature. And here, for example, the temperature from the weather station. So this is everything is done. Here on the right side, we see the group address view, the complete group address structure with main groups, middle groups, subgroups, and here all group addresses. So now what I have done is I have modified a little bit more this temperature and the weather outside temperature. Yeah, I will not only to see the value, I want also to record the values. And then you have to click here on the button trends and ticket here. Yeah, and then all historical values are now recorded. Good. Okay. What else? Some important information. One of the first is here the button settings. When we go to the settings, we can do some settings about the LAN communication. Yeah. And we have to tick here the cloud communication. So enable cloud portal. Yes. And enable remote access. That's what we need later if we want, for example, to register the device in the My Building portals. So please take care that these 2 fields are now here ticked. Okay, and then upload the settings. And here you can see the communication via twisted pair. So this is one of the first step. If you have still, or you are not sure, if you have the latest software version, then click here on the button upgrade, and click on the button scan. And then you get a list here of all IoT dashboard servers in your local IP network. And you see here the software version is now 1.20.11, which is the last one. If it's not 1.20.11 or older one, then you can make here update via the cloud, or you can upload the file from our website, abb.com/knx, store it on the hard disk and select here the folder where you have downloaded this update file and start here the update manually. That is also possible. Good. For more information, you can read the handbook. The handbook is here integrated. So very easy. You click only here on the button user guide. And then you get here the online help with all the information, technical data, the commissioning. And when you click on the button PDF, a PDF file is created and stored locally on your hard disk. Good. So far, what else? Here are our group addresses. Maybe you have created your complete ETS project and you have missed to create a group address. We need another one here in the IoT dashboard server. What can you do? You can click here on the middle group, right mouse click, and click on the button add new group address. So when you click here, a new field opens. So here you can enter the new name of the group address, guest room, for example, 300, and what is it? XYZ, doesn't matter. and start the group address should be have 31211. And if you want, you can set here also the data point type and add. And then this group address is now added here. You see the guest room 31211. And what happens? You see here the synchronize button now becomes orange. So what we have to do, we have to synchronize now this new group addresses with the ETS. But before we do it, yeah, we also add here another room. Maybe you have missed here one room in our building structure. Then we can do the same. We click here on the button, right mouse click, add new room. And then, for example, we enter here the name, which is, for example, the housekeeping. Doesn't matter. And we click on the button add. So and now when we press the button synchronize, this changes now this new room and the new group addresses are synchronized now with the ETS. And when we have a look in the ETS and everything works correctly, then we will see here is our new room housekeeping and our new group address 31211 guest room 301 XYZ. So this works in both directions, the synchronization from the ETS to the IoT dashboard tool and also vice versa. Oh, sorry, wrong button. So here, good. Okay, then another nice feature is the templates. Like for example here, I have created my guest room with the control element for switching, temperature and everything else. And then I can define, maybe this is a template. Yeah. I go here to the button information and here we have template. At the moment it's no template. I click here on the three dots and I can say you are a new template. For example, this is for a typical, what is it, for guest room template version, for example 001, and apply. So I give a name to this template. And then you will see also the color change here to brown because I use this as a template. And then I can go here to my room number 302. The same again to the button information, template. I click here on the button and say, hey, please use exactly an existing template, my guest room template version 001. Apply. And then you will see we have exactly the same buttons here like in my room 301. And this I can do also my room 303. Say, okay, I use the same template. I use the existing template, a guest room template, this one, and so on. So this helps you really if you have maybe the same type of rooms. Yeah, you create a template and all these three rooms now here uses the same template. What does it mean? When I shift now this button here and this here, maybe in this position, yeah, what happens in the other rooms? What can you see? It has also changed here in the other rooms. Also my room 301, 302, because if I make a change here on the 301, 302 or 303, doesn't matter. I have every time the same template. It affects also the other rooms. Good. So far, it is a nice feature of the templates. So then I want to add some controls. Like for example, I want to change the color of my LED strip. So I go here to the button controls and use, for example, here a so-called RGBW control element via drag and drop. I can make it a little bit maximize. So what else? I use, for example, here for DALI light. I want to switch and dim a DALI ballast. And I want to see also some more information, for example, a lamp failure. That's why I use here a DALI one. So what else? We can integrate also some shutters. Where are the sunblind shutters? Via drag and drop, a sunblind shutter, for example. Also more space, I need a little bit more. And okay, like this one. What else? A scene or a sequence. I find it here in the application, a local scene and a sequence. So some only example of some elements. Good, the next step is I click on my controls and I set the parameters. So we go here to the menu parameters on the right side. And at first, generally, I can write here name RGB. Looks not really nice. Like say, for example, it's better to write here LED strip. And then you will see the name changes here, LED strip. the color, maybe yellow for liked. I can enter here a tooltip comment. I can change the icon if I want. Yeah, presentation, here we have no parameter. But here in the function, we can select only RGB, RGB white, warm white, cold white, and such things. But here I have only the standard DALI gateway for RGB color, for RGB red, green, and blue. What I have to change, this control should not listen to a 3-byte channel telegram. It should listen to 3 1-byte objects. So like here, because all our DALI gateways supports this 3 1-byte channel information. Good, and then it's not difficult. Yeah, we have, and the next step, we have to link our group addresses like in the ETS. So you see here, when you click on the button assignment, you see here, for example, the red command, the red status, green, blue, and so on. And then we do the same in the ETS. We go here to our group addresses, like for example, my group number 1, which is the red one. I link it now with the group object value via drag and drop, link it to here. And the same for the status, which is the next group address. So and then I take the group address of my group number 2, which is the green one, to the green command, and the status of the green group number 2, link it to here. And the same for the blue. Blue is my group number 3. I take here the 1-byte value and the status of the 1-byte. So that is all. Good. And so we have configured, set a parameter, and linked the group addresses. So next, the DALI. And this is with this control, we want to switch and dim our DALI, DALI ballast number 1. So when you click on this control, you see here the objects for switching, for status, for brightness, brightness status, and also here for ballast or lamp failure. So we want later to see, or I can simulate here lamp failure, and then you will see the icon here changes. So the same again, I take here the group address for switching, link it to the object switching, the next for the status, I link it to the object for status, the same for the brightness value, and for the status of the brightness value. And the last group address, 3156, which is the lamp or ballast fault, lamp failure. I selected URL, for example, a lamp failure. I get it here from the DALI gateway, this information. So also done. Then I do the same here for my sunblind slider. I can do also here some settings. We go to the parameters, like for example, the icons and the text and so on. Yeah, such things are possible, but I still keep it. But you see here the objects like in the ETS for move to position of the height, move the sleds, the status of the height, the status of the upper end position, and for example, wind alarm. Wind alarm makes sense because if the end user wants to operate his control element and there's wind alarm, and then you see here red message, and then he knows, okay, wind alarm, high priority, he cannot operate it. So, but time is running. Let's come. That's why I still don't link the group addresses. Let's come now here to the local scene. Local scene is, we can also have here more scenes. At first, we have to link here our controls. You see, this is for the liked on the ceiling, which is the upper one, like this one here, or here our RGB. So we take here our control, like, and for example, and link it here via drag and drop to our scene, the 1-bit object, or the 1-byte object, we can select. I want to have the 1-bit and the 1-byte object. You see switch and brightness, the light on the ceiling, for example, and also, for example, here the shutter. I can also via drag and drop, like move to position height. Yes, I can also link here my RGB, why not? So then I go here to the button scenes. I give the first scene here a number, for example, this is my welcome scene. I can change here the icon, which looks like really welcome. So when I come home, for example, this icon, and I set now the value when I call the scene, when I click later my web user interface, or when I call the scene via KNX Telegram. What about, for example, DALI switch command? What would I like to have? Okay, I want to switch on, for example, when I call the scene. Brightness value is not used in the scene, but for example, here my switch command, I want to switch the light on. And the shutter, for example, should drive in the position 20%. So if I want another scene, I click here on the button plus. I write here the name, television, change the icon. Where is Television set. Where is the television set? This looks like a television set. Okay. And again, I can set here some parameter. I do not want to switch off because I want to have a brightness, for example, of 80%. Yeah, here, disliked, yeah, should, for example, switched off. And the shutter, for example, should drive in the position 70%. So you can create, of course, more of the scenes. And the sequencer is similar. The only difference is, let me add here some elements, like on the ceiling, sunblind. Yeah, the principle is still the same. We are drag and drop. But here we have another feature, which is our delay time. So now when we trigger the sequence, yeah, and then after 1 second, he sent this command, then maybe 4 seconds later, he sent this command with, for example, on, and again, maybe here, for example, 10 seconds later, he sent position go to 50%. It's also possible. I can also copy, for example, these buttons, right mouse click, copy, and I can paste it. And maybe again, 10 seconds later, he drives to 70%. So I can create here my sequences. Of course, I can start the sequence via KNX Telegram or later in the WebUser interface. Good, okay, so far overview of some, I think, important controls. Then let me upload all this information at first, save to my IoT dashboard server. So I click here on the button upload. I can scan again, then get here the list of all my IoT dashboard server in my local network. So you see here, when you click here, then this IP address 150 is copied here in the address field, and I click only here on the button upload. And then this project is now downloaded to my IoT dashboard server. So we have to wait some seconds. So please wait. So do not forget, when everything is finished, everything is done, click on the button synchronize to get to update also the filter table entries in our line couplers and area couplers or IP routers. So just wait. Okay, upload was now done. So everything is finished, everything's done. I click here on the button synchronize. And then when I go back here to the ETS, you will see, for example, when I click on my technical room, here is my IoT dashboard server, and here's my IP router. You see the group address flag here is missing because I have to download the new filter table entries. Now, when I click here on my IP router and go here to preview filter table, then you will see, this group address here now is used in different lines, 0471, and now it is in the filter table. Now, this is what the ETS is doing automatically. Like, for example, when you click here on the group address 0471, you see it is linked to a device 918, which is my weather station or analog input. And it is also linked here to my IoT dashboard server 937. And then this address here is in the IP router of line number 93 and in the IP router 91. Good. Okay, then. Let's show you everything live. First step is I have to log in with the dashboard. I have to enter here the IP address, which is my address 150. Log in admin minus 1234. This is my password. Oh, something wrong. Just a second. Admin minus 1234. Okay. So I made a mistake. Good. Now I'm logged in as the administrator. So you see here the guest room 301. Yeah, still the buttons here for switching the light on and off. You see the status. I have now switched off. When I press here my control element, you see the status changes here. Now maybe you hear also the clicking of the relay. So, or when I change here, for example, the color, like for example, I switch on now the red. It's red group number one. Yeah, and then you should see here the status. Why not? Blue. Okay, just let me switch on the red one. Yeah, you see the color change here, depending what I do here in my training board. Now I have only switched on group number two, which is the green one. That's why you can see here the green status. Now when I switch on group number one, which is the red one, and then you see green and red equals yellow. So here you can mix the color. You can also define some presets, like here, you click here on this button and say, okay, instead of white, I want to have exactly this color, also possible. Good, DALI liked is here, for example, here I can switch on, for example, my group number one. So now you see 100%. When I dim darker, say for example here 50%, yeah, you see here the status about 50%. Yeah, it's only the bulb here is half full. I can also, for example, dim here darker in steps. Yeah, I can dim brighter. And now I simulate a lamp failure. I have here a switch and disconnect the LED strip. And some seconds later, you will see here the lamp failure. You see here the broken lamp. Okay, I replace here the lamp. And then after some seconds, you will see everything is now fine. No more lamp failure. Everything is good. Or here the shutter control, for example, here I have the two scenes. Remember here my welcome scene, or here, for example, my television scene. You see here, switch off, the shutter drives in position, and here the brightness changes. Or here the sequence, when I click here and play, then you see, for example, here the timeline, 1 second, 3 seconds, and then different things happens here in my KNX installation. Good, so far here the IoT dashboard. What else? Product manual. So if you want to read more about this product, we have here also a button, product manual. So now when you click here, then again, the product manual opens and you can also download it as a PDF file. Good. Sorry, what else? So then we come, sorry, just a second. So then we come to the topic of favorites. So what are favorites? So now at a default, this page here is now empty. So I can go here to my room 301. So, okay, where's my room 301? I click here on the button edit mode, and then you will see all controls get here small additional icons with a heart. So I say, okay, this is, for example, my favorite, and my weather is a favorite. And then when I close the edit mode, stop the edit mode, and I go back to my favorites, and then these two elements now appears here in my favorite view, like for example here for switching, or to see here for example the outside temperature. This is one possibility to use the favorites. Links, via links we can jump to one of our rooms, for example, like here again I go to my room 301. So now when I click again here the edit mode, and you see here, I have a new button on the right upper side, add link. When I click now here, so I can write here a name, like for example, this is my guest room 301, and click on the button save. I stop now the edit mode, close, and then you will see when I click here on the button links, I get here a link to my guest room 301, also possible. Or my temperature, like here. Remember, I have still enabled this trend function. And now when I click here on these blue icons, I get here some more details or some more possibilities, like here, trend data. When I click here, then I jump here to the trend view. Like here, for example, today, I can see here maybe the temperature. So today I have no more historical more values because at 12 Uhr, I made a factory reset of this IoT dashboard server to be prepared for this online session now. That's why I have no more historical data. Good, and here, for example, the temperature. You can also save this page as a link to the favorites. I write here a name. For example, this is the temp in my 301. Click on the button save. And then when I close it and go back, for example, here to my links, and then you will see here I can jump to my guest room, or I can jump here to this page of my trend of my room temperature. Good, only a short overview of this real powerful trend solution. Good, then we come to the portal. Oh, time is running. So we want to register the device in our My Buildings portals because we want to have access from outside. So what we have to do, we go here to the overview and here to the settings. And here we have the so-called device settings. So now click here on device settings. You see here the settings of the LAN communication port 1. Yeah, LAN number 2 is not used, but here we have the so-called cloud registration. Okay, so here we have to enter our username of the My Buildings portal. Yeah, so this is exactly, just go here to the portal, what you enter here, the username and the password of your My Building portals. So you have to enter it, for example, here. So this is my user login. So I have to enter the password and maybe a name, ABBXYZ, and click on the button register to portal. So wait some seconds and now we see everything is live, everything is real. Yeah, the device is now registered in the My Building portals. Let's check it again. I go here to My Building portals. Yeah, I use the same login, the same password. Oh, just made a mistake. Okay, good. So I go here to My Home. You can find here the IoT dashboard. And here you see exactly the device ABBXYZ. Now the registration was really successful. So to use, for example, the Building Care extension or the DALI Manager application, I have to use a license, to buy a license. Or, for example, we have the possibility to use, for example, a free test phase. Yeah? So you can, for free of charge, you can use this portal, the extension Building Care and DALI Manager until the end of this year. So I want to use it. I click here on the button, start free. So, and then you see here what happens, trial period. I select here as a license, the trial period. And I have to go again. Oh, sorry, it was too fast, sorry. I have to again click here on the free test phase for the DALI Manager. Yes, I want to use it. And then I have the possibility like here to use the test trial period. So, okay, everything is now done. I go back to my IoT dashboard. So, and go here to my additional application. So I go here to applications and here you can see the DALI Manager application. So I click here and now you see the license was successful because up to the end of the year, last day of December, my free of charge license works. You see it is installed, everything is fine. And it is similar like in our IBAS tool. I need now the individual address of my DALI gateway. So my DALI gateway has the individual address 938 and click on the button connect. So now the DALI Manager application reads out the settings of my DALI gateway. It will last some seconds. You see here 13%. Good. So this DALI Manager app is similar like the IBAS tool. So we can do the same. We can trigger the addressing. We can link devices, ballast into groups, yeah, such typical things, some diagnostic. The advantage is here that we have access to our installation from outside the building via the portal. Yeah, so you have not to be inside the building and start this IBAS tool inside the building. Or you can use your tablet. Yeah, and via the tablet, independent operating system, you have access to your DALI gateway. Yeah. I can promise you the next time when you start again this DALI Manager app, it is faster. 100%. Okay, you see it's connected. You get here some information, DALI gateway supply voltage, everything is okay. The connected devices, the monitors, number of monitor devices, yeah, the same information like we have in our IBAS tool. So and then we can click here on this button and then we get, again, he's loading all the informations. And then in some seconds we get here the similar page like we have in the IBAS tool, the 16 groups and our 64 ballast. And on the right side, you can still see here our different buttons, for example, yeah, to reset a selected device, yeah, or to clear the group memberships. The typical buttons we have also in the ETS. Yeah, the automatic DALI addressing at the moment, it is not used. So here via this DALI manager application, we can also trigger the addressing. To start addressing, you have to press here these three small dots here you can see, yeah, and then you get here another possibility to trigger the addressing. Okay, all information are now downloaded. So via a click, for example, I can click here my ballast number 2 and then my red LED strip goes on. You see here also the status, it is still on. Yeah, or when I click here my group number 2, the same again, you see here group number 2 is now on, which is for example my green LED. And the same here via drag and drop, you can also change here the addresses like we do it in the IPAS tool. So the same features. Yeah, and here you get the overview, you see the parameterization and the ETS and what is really in the device, if it's group or single, you see here all this information. So when you click here, then you get here also some detailed information. Good, so far a small introduction of the DALI Manager app. Good, okay, the last nice feature, because I have to come to the end, is here the diagnostics tools. So when you click here on diagnostics on the dashboard, we have here the possibility to record telegrams, like we can do it in the group monitor, like here group addresses. We say yes, activate. And now when I press here one rocker, yeah, you see the information now here, yeah, the group telegram is stored. You see the source address, this is my control element. It's a command value write, the group address, the value 0 or 1. It is a switch, the data point type, including the timestamp and the text description. So this is similar like the group monitor. Ooh, good. Okay, so far I have now to stop this presentation because time is running. Good, then let's come. Here I stop sharing now my desktop. Let's come to the end. Good, okay, so far this was my presentation today about these further functions and features of the IoT Dashboard Server DBS. And now I give back to Thorsten. Thanks for listening. Have a good day and goodbye.
Great, Jürgen, thank you a lot for this various information. I think a lot, but if you see how it's been done, it's not, I think, not so difficult to follow if you get it demonstrated. And it's a kind of collection of tips and tricks you have got right now. So for me, very interesting is a template, really saves time. You create a template for a room, then you can use it in many other rooms if you have many rooms the same style. The DALI manager was shown and explained by Jürgen. So remote access is now possible to the DALI part of the IBAS tool in principle, and you can use any browser. So that's also a big benefit here, and with almost all functions behind. Yeah. Scene and sequence you have seen. You don't assign group addresses, but you assign the controls. And sequence is a different from the scenes that you can create a timeline, so delay between sending out the telegrams from your sequence. Yeah, and many more functions you have seen. So we did not cover everything up to now, but I think most. Allow me to come to my final slides as always. So homepage, of course, is clear where you get all information, including the manual also here available. Also the dashboard server tool you need to configure is available here. So everything on the homepage. Our range overview is clear. Our training material will be stored all on our training and qualification database, including the session from today a bit later, everything there, including videos on our YouTube channel. So yeah, our calendar, training qualification calendar, more or less contains our online learning sessions and webinars, not more at the moment because we have no classroom trainings. We will see what is possible. And what we are looking for is to have at least maybe the certified trainings at the more or less at the end of the year. Not clear at the moment. We are still optimistic. We will inform you when we can continue with our presence trainings and our classroom trainings. Okay. Yeah, what is planned next? Tomorrow already a further webinar about KNX RF, radio frequency, wireless communication based on the KNX technology, not completely new, but more and more people are asking for this. Also, the certified training centers have to handle this in the trainings now, and the certified training, the basic training. So therefore, we would like to give you some information what is possible here in this solution, and it's tomorrow at 9 or 3 o'clock. And a further webinar after more or less our not real summer holidays, so only a short time. We have a break on the 19th of August. In August, we would like to continue with further system family of product solutions, ABB Assess Control. So this is something relatively new, but it's coming now to the market, and we would like to inform you about this as well. Online learning sessions not planned for the next time, but also in latest September we will continue here. I will send you still later the first feedback mail with a PDF file of the presentation at least. Not much. Wait for the video, comes a bit later because we have to edit this still a bit. And then you get also the recording of the demonstration of yoga. It's the most useful one. Okay, thank you for your patience and your participation. Hope to see you tomorrow to the next webinar, KNX RF, otherwise later. Thank you, see you, bye-bye, ciao.